And I'd say with that, we're going to go ahead and move on to our video segment here because we talked about that way too much and we got quite a number of videos to go through.
Well, boss, let's face it.
We got to get to videos. So let's move on. All right, we're going to go ahead and get into our video segment now. And of course, we're going to start off with what's going to turn out to be the next few weeks of Celeb Pony Jeopardy. And I am not apologizing for this. This stuff is hilarious. But first, quickly, while everybody gets into our side tube here, we're going to quickly update the images. Okay, you know what? There we go. Perfect. All right, and yes, unfortunately, yeah, there's another MILF for the MILF collection. Pretty sure everybody's already aware of it.
Yep.
All right, so.
Boots episode. That's your opinion.
All right, so let's go ahead and get started here. In 3, 2, 1.
Welcome back to Celebrity Jeopardy. I apologize for what happened before the commercial and would like to assure the audience that all three contestants are now wearing pants. That said, let's take a look at the scores. Ozzy Osbourne has negative $79,000.
Honestly, I see Gobble as Ozzy.
Stuart has a commanding lead with 0.
Alex, I've transformed this simple game show podium into a rich cornucopia of winter flora. Using dried figs and snow-tipped eucalyptus. I really treasure it.
Wow. And in third place, Sean Connery.
Oh, no.
We meet again, Trebek. I noticed you weren't able to sit down during the break. What's wrong, sweetie? Did you have a date last night?
Thank you, Mr. Connery. Now let's take a look at the categories for Double Jeopardy. They are potent quotables, drummers named Ringo, states that begin with California, Richard Nixon, the number after 2, famous Kareem Abdul-Jabbar's, and finally, don't do anything. What is it, Mr. Connery?
Knock, knock.
No. Who's there?
Me, the guy who slept with your mother last night.
Let's just go with drummers named Ringo for 400. And the answer is, this Ringo was the star drummer for the Beatles. Martha Stewart.
I'm so terribly lonely.
I know. Sean Connery, the drummer for the Beatles.
Craven Moorhead.
Who is Craven Moorhead?
Apparently you are.
Ozzy, please. The answer, of course, is Ringo Starr. Mr. Osborne, you get to choose.
Choose? Oh, I'll take Charleston Choose for 60 million.
Let's just go with don't do anything. The answer is don't do anything. Don't ring your buzzer. Just remain motionless and you all win. Mr. Osborne, you just lost. Well, at least the two other contestants. Why did you ring your buzzer?
Because that sound reminds me of a yellow-throated New England warbler.
Well, congratulations, Mr. Connery. You were... did you do that?
Because I hate you, Trebek.
I swear it sounded like Daryl Hammond was about to lose it.
Yeah, it did.
Looky what I did. Fantastic. All right, let's just end this final Jeopardy. The category is, you know what, I'll tell you what. The category is things you like. Just write down or draw a picture of something you like. If you like,
oh god, is this the one I think it is?
Draw a circle.
Probably.
Osborne could draw a Charleston chew. Mr. Connery could draw me hanging myself. Anything at all. Well, let's start with Ozzy Osbourne. He wrote monkeys. Fine. That's great. You like monkeys.
No, I hate monkeys. They're awful. I had a monkey one time, but he wouldn't drink alcohol. So, I bit his bloody head off.
There's something wrong with your brain.
There's a lot wrong with this brain.
Let's see what she wrote. Absolutely nothing.
Alex, I'm filthy rich. I don't need your chump change.
You're playing for charity.
Screw him.
Ow.
Seek some counseling. And finally, Sean Connery, you wrote Alex Trebek. I can't believe it. Something you like is me.
Oh, laddie. I know I'm hard on you, but it's all in good fun.
Well, I don't know what to say. Let's see how much you wager. Sucks.
There was a moment.
I can't believe I fell for that. So long from Celebrity Jeopardy. Good lord. What?
Like I said, we're going to have these for a while. And now we're gonna have that one too.
Ooh, what filter are you going to use, darling?
I was thinking about going hashtag no filter.
Not to sound like Granny Smith, but why do y'all care so much about a filter? All it does is make a new picture look old.
No,
they are so wrong.
I kind of agree with
the
Sunset and Applejack.
Shape chic?
I'd never wear a dodecahedron.
If you're missing your friends, try Flora / Barnett. Check it out! We're in a band.
We do that already.
What?
Okay, I.
Normal hair. You guys look great.
Actually, I kind of like how the hair actually moved normally for a moment.
Sorry, I have to admit, I chuckled at the fisheye joke.
I like the big. Okay, now that that one got me. That one got me. And now, more Celeb Pony Jeopardy.
Here we go, again.
Granted, this is the last one for the night, because we had a lot of videos.
Welcome back to Celebrity Jeopardy. I thought we were done with this, but Regis Philbin, that mongrel idiot, decided to do a Celebrity Millionaire, and network competition being what it is, I stand before you, a broken and miserable man. Let's take a look at the scores. Sean Connery has set a new Jeopardy record for futility with
Shuck on it, Trebek. Shuck it long and shuck it hard.
That's beautiful. Do you kiss your mother with that mouth?
No, but I did something to your mother with this mouth.
Okay. Why? Keanu Reeves has an impressive negative $32,000.
I know Kung Fu.
For the last time, no you don't. And finally, Hillary Swank in a commanding lead with zero.
Did I win? Because there's some people I need to thank.
Let's just take a look at the board. And the categories are potent potables, foreign flicks, things Trebek sucks. Wait. All right. Let's continue. Potpourri, hot or cold, what ears do, is this a hat? That's where I name an object and you tell whether or not it's a hat. And finally, colors that end in herbal. Hello, Swank. You're in the lead, so we'll start with you.
I'm a girl, you know.
Let's just go with foreign flicks for 800.
Ursula Andress.
What?
Ursula Andress, Catherine Deneuve, and Charles Twice.
That's foreign flicks, Mr. Connery.
Ah.
Shall take balloons for 800, if you please.
That's not a category.
My mistake. I shall choose balloons for 600.
I'll tell you what, let's do colors that end in herbal for 800. This color ends in herbal. Hillary Swank.
What is light herbal?
Wow. Keanu Reeves.
I will venture a guess. Who is Jaleel White?
What?
Is that not the gentleman who played Urkel, the humorous fellow with the glasses who loves cheese?
That's Urkel. Oh, good. Mr. Connery wants to say something.
I thought of some more foreign ladies I snogged.
Let's just go to hot or cold for 400. Video daily double. Here goes nothing. Please take a look at your video monitors. No one can figure out if the hot tea is hot or cold. Thank God, Keanu Reeves.
Is it iced tea?
No, it's hot tea.
Well, then I have no idea.
Let's just go to Final Jeopardy. The category is... Oh, come on, why would they do this? The category is famous mothers.
My day has come.
Anything.
Hand and special pen, and move the pen around. Scribble if you want to, just make some kind of mark. Okay, let's get this over with. Sean Connery, you wrote down below. Don't know why you wrote that, but technically that's a correct answer. You did write something. Let's see what you wagered. Me. Below me. Below me. I don't get it.
Oh, I'll bet you do, you Canadian punch.
Proud day for you and your family. Keanu Reeves, you look rather pleased. Let's see what you wrote down. Nothing. The question was right, anything, and you got it wrong. I'm speechless. Let's see what you wagered. $70 billion. That's not even a real number.
Yet.
Simply amazing. And finally, Hillary Swank.
Thank you, Alec. I'm so honored to have been here today. So many people I have to thank. I couldn't have done it without...
Oh, God.
The incredible cast and crew of Jeopardy. My publicist, who was a beautiful human being. That's it.
Touching. That's all for Jeopardy. Regis, you can have him. Good night.
And now, Big Brother Best Friend Forever live acoustic cover.
Dad, he's a tenor.
With Red Dead and now, two best sisters play Red Dead Redemption 2!
...to create a living world that's not simply open, but deeper.
Come on, pretty boy.
More interactive and detailed than ever.
This doesn't look like Game of the Year to me.
This is a Western game, though, so...
Yeah, sure, I'm in the West, but, like, this is... Look at it!
Shoot him!
Why would I shoot him?
Oh,
he's running. Oh, fuck it, whatever. Oh,
whoa.
Sweet. First person?
That's pretty sweet.
Patience. Wait, I can murder someone in broad daylight? The town only gives kind of a fuck?
Your actions have consequences, and it's up to you to decide just how honorable Arthur is.
What happens if I kill another guy?
Maybe the town will have more patience.
What the fuck? Why do they have so much more patience? Even though they're dead. They're dead right here.
Oh, well, I guess it was God's will.
No!
Each weapon has unique characteristics, with realistic reload and recoil that always keeps the player grounded and connected to the action in a gunfight. Get into ruckus altercations, fight a duel, and a lot more.
Where?
With that dog over there.
Okay, fine. Fuck you, dog.
Showdown!
Oh my god! Why is it so hard?
This is a world that is rich in depth and detail, all designed to be explored on horseback or on foot.
Thank you.
What the hell?
What are you doing? Smell the cigars, lady.
Oh, God. Oh, what is that truck simulator that just went a big red?
Hunting helps the camp or earns you money. Wound an animal, and you'll have to track them down. Animal pelts and other items you find can be traded for cash to use at general stores, gunsmiths,
Why won't you die?
Skin mark attacks or something.
But like the horse can't.
How do you kill?
A horse can't hurt a buffalo.
Jump on him?
Okay. Oh my god, my horse can jump like a boss.
Over time, the bond between you and your horse will grow, making them easier to control in tense situations.
Yeah, he's a great horse, aside from when the devil got him.
What?
Your saddle and saddlebags can store extra weapons, along with supplies and animal carcasses that you pick up while out roaming or hunting. A rich and varied ecosystem thrives in the world, full of predators, prey, and scavengers. All smart and sometimes deadly.
Holy shit. You are knifing that bear the fuck up. Cut his face, man. Cut him so bad.
Got a drink.
Fighting have both been radically improved to make combat deep and engaging at all times.
Jesus, this is taking longer than I anticipated.
Oh man, you're almost out of whiskey. Just cut his face. Cut his face.
He's almost dead.
Oh, you're almost dead. Oh my god. Understand what the fuck he's saying?
It's all garbled.
I can kind of get it.
Bacon?
Like, but it's all Western. Can you fucking, like, back out and, like, turn on subtitles?
Subtitles?
Yeah. It's display, right?
Alright.
Okay. Alright, thanks a lot, man. Finally understand what the fuck that guy was saying.
Alright, good.
Wait, what the fuck? Where'd he go? Whatever.
Yay, picnic.
Student council in a nutshell.
BRB. Okay, now picnic. Yay, picnic. BRB. Okay, I'm back.
So
you've
much teleporting.
Too much can be bad. BRB. Can be bad for your brain if you teleport too many times. BRB.
Oh, there's a gif of just
too
all
many
of the
times,
teleports.
You can start forgetting.
Of this episode, it's
BRB.
It's beautiful.
Okay, I'm back. Forgetting things. BRB. Okay, I'm back. What did I just say? Sorry, I forgot. I am doing a report on Roquet Traces, but I need help writing a letter to Live Stream. I have to help many ponies. Okay, I'll be back later, Mole. Are you ready for the party stoplight? What party? Mute's party that we're helping with.
Sorry, I forgot.
Because you're teleporting too much.
Okay, I will get the dishes and decorations. BRB. Okay, now I will get the flowers.
What the hey, I'm getting flowers.
Sorry, I forgot.
All that teleporting is damaging her memory.
BRB. Hi, I need a cake recipe.
Trixie already got it.
Sorry, I forgot. BRB. What the heck?
Stop light, stop teleporting. Stop light,
how?
I have a question about our catrices.
Sorry, live stream, I have to bake a cake.
We bring cake.
Yay, cake.
Now we can celebrate the spring solstice.
Don't you mean the spring equinox?
What the heck?
The solstice occurs twice a year when the path of the sun is farthest away from the Earth's equator on either the first day of summer or the first day of winter. However, an equinox occurs when the path of the sun is directly overhead the Earth's equator twice a year, on either the first day of spring or the first day of autumn. The word solstice is derived from a Latin phrase meaning standing sun due to the fact that the summer solstice is the longest day of the year for the residents of whichever hemisphere the path of the sun.
Sorry, I forgot.
She's been teleporting.
Yes, but not anymore. Let's enjoy the party. No more teleporting.
Stop light, help, I can't find Livestream.
Okay, BRB.
Looks like she was tooting rocketrices. Why didn't you mention it earlier?
Sorry, I forgot. Let's look for a live stream in the ever-free forest.
Oh no, rocketrix. Rock-a-doodle-doo. Don't make eye contact or you'll become a rock.
Let's get out of here. Wait, where's Mud Brian?
Oh no.
If only there was a safe place around where a live stream might be. Like maybe a magical treehouse or something. That would be very helpful right now. What? Sorry, I forgot.
Yeah, live stream, you're okay.
I met a rockatress, lol.
Mud Brian needs help, I guess. Bog, 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 you're not a rock.
Yay.
Yay, let's go back to the party.
Actually, this isn't a party anymore. It's an intervention. You really need to cut back on the teleporting stoplight.
Okay. Who is stoplight?
Who is stoplight?
And now, step by step, Flutter.
First of all, I know many of you have seen a music video with some sassy girls. Did you like my cameo, by the way? Yes, a wonderful video with many views, and let me tell you, I can't blame all of you for watching it again and again.
That video is simply the creation of a
genius. Discord? Why don't you see that I made you a star? They love you.
He said that I wasn't the Flash I knew.
Yeah, those losers wouldn't know a new approach if it stripped naked, painted itself purple, stood on a box in the middle of the town screaming, "New approaches are here again." Anyway, come on, say hello to your fans.
No! You better resume your apology, mister. I'm gonna be mad forever.
Okay. So many of you watched a video with three pretty dancers with some, how should I say, weird happenings in it. So many of you started asking, why is Fluttershy behaving like that? Why isn't Twilight Sparkle leading? Why isn't it Rainbow Dash instead of Pinkie Pie? Pinkie doesn't flutter. Well,
don't you just love it when
all by my hand in elaboration. I'm the, well, producer of that video, and I thought it would be better with some chaos. I'm the god of chaos, can you blame me? But didn't ask my dear friend Fluttershy if she wanted to be brave enough to be a star in my video before doing anything, so I made her mad at me, so sorry. She's not sassy, she doesn't even like the stage, she's shy, and she likes it that way.
Auntie, I forgive you.
And I'm not doing that again.
You aren't crossing your fingers, are you?
Can I proceed with Arthur? You promised to lend you if I apologize?
Okay.
Mares and gentle goats, as many of you wanted a step-by-step of flutter dance, myself and the other performer who appreciates the choreography of a genius are going to show you how to do just that. First thing is... Huh? She doesn't flutter? Too fussy. Beth. Well, there's one, two, three, four. Break that pose and hit that floor. Now back and forth on the floor. Now turn your back to the audience and five, six, seven, eight. And don't forget to nod that head. Let's elevate. Now it's time to flutter like this and that. A little spin. Yes, that's perfect. Just back. Yes. Now pay attention to the model's hand movement. Yes, spin. Move your shoulders and do a little shake. Move your hands like this. Some people say I copied those dazzling moves, but nope, they copied me. Throw your hands down. And up. Down again. Flutter. One, two, one, two. Show 'em, girl. Yeah. That's all, folks. Hope you enjoyed the little step-by-step, and I hope you enjoy my next music video.
What video? What are you talking about?
Nothing. I just forgot that project is canceled. Flutter lot numbers so that you like it a lot.
Oh, whoops, there's more. Sorry.
I'm not responsible for anything related to video.
I'm gonna be real with you, Chief. That made me feel uncomfortable. And this is me we're talking about.
I don't know, I didn't mind it.
It's not bad, it's just one of those things of,
It made me feel uncomfortable. Circuit, I don't know, man. I might have to go to HR about this.
My name is Fluttershy, and I am...
Well, here's Fluttershy.
How can I help you?
God damn it.
Super excited.
Hey, I'm the only one that admits that pose, so...
There's a reason no one goes to HR. We tried to get him fired. Yeah, I think
it's been a year. Unfortunately, I also am manager when Circuit's not around.
Actually, we don't have an HR department.
That's not true at all. And if it is, I'm leaving this network.
We don't have an HR department. We can't do anything.
Oh, I can't do anything, but it's all for the fun.
No, it's not. You're horrible, and we hate you for it.
So what is going on here?
This is Fluttershy reacts to Friendship is Manly.
I always love these somewhat parodies of the whole reaction thing.
But what if he finds out? Oh, my goodness. Oh, is that me? Whoa. I've been doing a little more than helping out animals. I've been helping out animals and lifting weights and just getting super buff. Buff shy now. It's okay. Why be assertive with your voice, and you can show how assertive you are. And Pinkie Pie looks great too, with her singable mood. Let's get into this party. It's super exciting.
Let's face drop.
Extremely ready to party. Oh, hold on. What's that? Party cannons? Wow. Okay. And there's Gummy. Gummy's so cute. And Mimi with my amazing dance moves. And Pinkie Pie just ruined all of the cake for everyone. Oh, goodness. What is she? That is not safe. Please don't do that. That is not safe. Please don't do that. The tea, it is hot. It is boiling. Gummy looks like he's having a good time. Who knew I could dance so well? Look at Pinkie Pie go. I'm so happy. Well. That was... I have no words. I am in a loss for words. I had no idea what to expect from that. I don't know. After watching this, I feel kind of inspired to go watch out and stuff. So I think I might just do that. I'm going to go feed Angel Bunny, and I'm going to go hit the gym or something. Not really, probably not. But, yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. I'm so sorry that it was so short, but, like, this video is something I've been wanting to react to in a long time, and I'm glad I got to do it, and I hope you guys like it. Until next time, bye!
And now, a sneak peek at the next Pinky Tales. And yes, there's another one.
The Huntsmare wasted no time finding Sky Blue to complete her task. She lured her into the woods under the pretense that some pony needed saving, something she knew a decorated hero such as Sky Blue could never overlook. However, as the hours passed, Sky Blue became suspicious of the unicorn and prodded more information out of her.
You know,
so, who did you say needed my help again?
Oh, a little, filly. She got lost in the woods and then trapped under a branch, which is why I brought the shovel, to dig her out.
I thought you said it was a colt.
No, it's definitely a filly.
So why do you need me here? Why didn't you just conjure up a shovel with your magic and save her hours ago?
Oh, well, you see... Oh, all right. It was all a lie. I'm actually just, your biggest fan. Yeah, that's it. And I've lured you out here to spend time with you and get your autograph.
The Huntsmare said, offering Sky Blue her hat with a forced smile. Sky Blue cocked her head to the side in confusion.
Huh. Clever. Never had a fan pull this before. Gotta give you props for creativity, I guess. Here.
Sky Blue took the hat and plucked out one of her feathers to use as a quill.
What's your name?
Pony... Horse?
Alrighty, there you go.
Sky Blue said with a wink.
Great. Oh, and I'm going to need that feather you just plucked.
Okay.
And I'm gonna need you to stay in the forest and never ever come back again.
Whoa, hold on!
Before Sky Blue could finish her thought, the Huntsmare took the shovel and hit her over the head. Sky Blue immediately fell to the ground, unconscious.
Huh. That was easy. Who knew these things were so effective? Ugh, pony horse? What was I thinking? Now the great and powerful Huntsmare has to find a new hat.
The Huntsmare said bitterly, before drinking from the potion vial that would teleport her back to the castle.
Well, now we just gotta wait for the actual video to come out. So here's a derpy robot repair.
One of the greatest things about being a robot, easy repair. Thank you.
I'm
still. All right.
I forgot I linked this to you.
You did. I didn't forget.
Yeah, Prince Whatever really knocked it out of the park.
Beautiful.
And now, comic dub fashion show.
Oh, work it, darling.
Rainbow Dash, darling, what are you wearing? What? You said I should wear a tank top. Oh, my goodness gracious, you are the epitome of stupidity, my darling. Darling Rainbow Dash, please, please tell me you will enroll in some remedial classes of some description because, quite honestly, at the moment, I'm not even entirely sure how you manage to feed yourself, darling, and manage to keep your home out of some kind of squalor that will eventually bury you in entire stacks of paper and you will die and not be found for months, and we will have to dig your body out of the wreckage and mourn you over your bones.
And now, booty call.
Booty, booty, booty.
Zecora can take the bad away if you do just what I say.
Really?
But before I can perform my duty, I'm going to need some of your booty.
Whoa. I know I can be quite fetching for my good looks, but this here booty of mine is already reserved for some pony else.
I was talking about your jewel, you silly misguided fool.
Oh. Are you sure you're not getting on me?
Alright. And unfortunately, that was our last video before our closer. So, that means it is time to say goodnight. So we got our closing music playing, and we're going to go ahead and let everybody who managed to survive all the way to the end get a shout out. Crazy Matt Captain.
Words, fires, explosions, Eloy, Ron, Vaz, Jerky.
Crazy, I already just said that.
So, oh wait, I should crash, or at least lay back.
Alright, Textalion.
Night all.
Then Toa Koi.
Shout out to all the lovely people that have viewed us and stuck around from the very beginning to talk. Admittedly long talk. Thank you to Angel of Light, Commander Root, Side of Motion, Jimmy Troll, Holy Tree in Studio, Lorex,
and Coldust.
Shouts out to me for figuring out how not to be the first person to give shoutouts. Yeah. I'm giving myself credit for that. Yeah. Also, shouts out to Pinkie Pie Panties and also my laundry, which I need to get.
Alright. Alright, then I'll go ahead and give the final shout out here. Thank you all for joining us for another episode of The Brony Show. Tune in next week where we are going to be talking about art and getting ready for the brand new artist training ground for the year. So make sure you have your artistic skills ready. Your pens, your pencils, your paper, your pads, whatever you use to write with, whatever you're going to work your arting on, make sure you have it. And we will have everything we can to give you ideas, suggestions, thoughts, creation topics, anything. We will do what we can to give you a big old guide of everything possible so you can make sure that you can have all of the art ability for you. Blah, English words me fail. So we're going to go ahead and get our final little shout-outs in. Of course, tune in, stay tuned for the Coffee House After Party. That will be at thebronyshow.net. Otherwise, tune in on Wednesday for Winchester Wednesdays, which can have all sorts of shenanigans. Everything from talking, from fanfic reading to talking about different stuff, building cities, managing farms, or being attacked on a distant planet. So many things can happen with Winchester Wednesdays, and you have to be there to see it all. Along with that, Friday, Roan RPG. We are fervently working hard to get our run group back together. Unfortunately, we had a few hiccups. I do apologize. But we are getting a massive story ready for our grouping. We want to make sure everything is lined up in a row so that they can end up going the complete wrong direction and setting everything on fire. Anyway, along with that,
we're going to take option 8, which is 5 more options away than what you're thinking of.
Yeah, pretty much. Of course, Saturdays, we usually have randomizer runs. This Saturday, we are setting up for another Zelda 64 randomizer run for multiplayer. Of course, that means that we have spots open for anybody who wants to join me and Cataclysm in running Zelda 64 completely randomized. Of course, it is on easy mode, so you don't have to worry about knowing too much about the game or getting completely and hopelessly lost or fishing for that one item that's out in the middle of nowhere. Along with that, Sunday, we have Grand Theft Auto shenanigans going on. So be sure to check that out as well as we continue going through heists. And, of course, tune in an hour early for the Equestrian Flag stuff with Cold Dust and his crazy shenanigans. Usually it's a jackbox, but they may surprise you one of these days. All you got to do is come and watch or participate.
Honestly, probably not this next week because, once again, I think I'm working overtime on Monday, and it's really hard to plan a proper show when you've worked 10 hours before.
Nah, I feel you there. So, and let's get our final little shout-outs in then. Our final little bits here. First off, I'd like to thank our chatters here. Crazy Matt Captain for keeping an eye on the chat. Thank you to Claudica Draconiquist, Cole, Cool Dude, 13233, Sarcasm, DM12, Fantastic Fred, Glass 4, Octavia Melody, Sonic 5421, Surreal Nightmares, Techman, Tech Stallion, Toakoi, Unidentified 4212435, and Vaguely Creepy. At least I think that's who's down there. It's kind of hard for me to tell. Yep, Vaguely Creepy. Also, I want to give a big shout out to all of our archivers that watch us on YouTube and also who watch us live on Twitch and YouTube as well. Thank you all for watching us however you can, whenever you can, wherever you can. I do this stuff for you, and I really appreciate getting your big thumbs up, your shout outs, your keep going, keep your love this stuff. Actually, I did get a post saying a moment ago somebody complimenting our latest episode. So that was nice. I love that. That was really nice. So thank you. Anyway, enough of the sappiness here. Let's get our final video in so we can get to the coffee house after party or let you people sleep because I'm sure you're exhausted. Pony Paradise or Paradise and Pony Style. Have a good night, everybody. That song was Paradise. I think I lost my pair of dice.